This is the Buffalo S2 Utility, and it has the most practical and reliable two-speed drivetrain ever to be installed on a bicycle. And it uses two big, heavy chains paired to entirely separate chainrings and cogs. To understand why this is, you have to understand what the Buffalo bicycle is for. Consider the case of Georgina, a dairy farmer in Zambia. Her farm has no refrigerators, and so they must transport their milk 12 kilometers away or risk losing an entire day's work. Before the Buffalo bicycle, they could only do this once per day, but now they do it twice, effectively doubling their output. Their Buffalo bicycle serves as a pickup truck, and if it stops working, they lose their produce. But there are no bicycle specialty tools in their village, nor can they order replacement parts on Amazon. That's what makes the Buffalo bicycle so unique. It's designed to be field serviceable with minimal tools. It's also cost-effective, and it has a rack rated for 200 pounds. And just like Georgina uses her Buffalo bicycle to increase her output, remote communities around the world use it to transport clean drinking water, medical supplies, and students, provided it's a community that's not too mountainous. Yeah, on steep grades, the original Buffalo bicycle became more of a cart for just pushing things along, owing to its single gear. So for the last 6 years, World Bicycle Relief has been developing a new two-speed Buffalo that can climb. Yes, the Buffalo S2 Utility has two gears, one for cruising and one for climbing, but the bicycle needed to be just as reliable and serviceable as its predecessor. And so, to accomplish this, it needed a near total redesign. And it may sound funny, but I actually get a little bit emotional about it. See, I review a lot of bicycles with cutting edge features. I love new technology, and this is new technology. But this is simpler than any other way we shift gears. It's simpler than an internal gear hub, it's simpler than a derailleur, and it's more reliable and cost effective than either. The Buffalo S2 represents everything that we love most about old bicycles, and indeed, what made me fall in love with bicycles in the first place. So today we're gonna take the Buffalo S2 for a ride. We're gonna take it apart, examine the accessories they include with it, and explore all the counterintuitive changes they made to the most practical bicycle in the world. This is the Buffalo S2 Utility, and I'm Seth from Berm Peak. Now, if you saw my last video on the original Buffalo, this is all gonna make a lot more sense. So here's a 30-second recap. World Bicycle Relief is a nonprofit that delivers bicycles to remote communities with limited resources. They even launched their own brand, Buffalo, to create a purpose-built machine for their mission. The tires are heavy duty. The rack can support up to 200 pounds. And the seat and grips are abrasion resistant, such that the bike can be turned upside down for service. To date, the Buffalo bicycle has mobilized over 4 million people, and what's more, it's created jobs. While many bicycles are donated, some are purchased from Buffalo bike shops run by locals. But out of those bicycles donated, this audience bought 160 of them, mobilizing an estimated 640 people. That's easily an entire village. Now, if you want to know more about that original Buffalo bicycle, you can watch my last video. But let's move on to this new exciting drivetrain. As you can see, each of these chains is paired to a different chain ring, providing a high gear for speed and a low gear for climbing. If you want to shift between either of these two gears, you simply kick the cranks back and start pedaling. It's that simple. But you'll notice that regardless of what gear we're in, both of these chains continue moving. That's because they're both attached to the same fixed crankset. All the work is happening back here at the freewheel. You can see back here at this freewheel mechanism, there are actually two cogs. And when you kick the pedals back, it's engaging or disengaging the outer cog. That's the higher gear. Now, if we disengage that higher gear by kicking the pedals back, now the lower gear drives the bike. And that gear just kind of sits there doing nothing, but of course you still see the chain move. Switch it back to the higher gear, and now it drives the bike, essentially running circles around the lower gear. Make sense? So it's only one of these cogs that's engaging or disengaging, yet these big heavy chains are always moving. It might seem a little bit crude, but it's actually brilliantly simple, and I'm not the only one with that opinion. The Buffalo S2 won two different awards for design at Eurobike, including the Gold Award in the bicycle category alongside high-end road bikes. It was also awarded the German Design Award for product engineering, which is no small feat. And in practice, this is the least finicky shifting experience I have ever had. There are no misshifts, there's no clicking. It just always works perfectly every single time. See, there are other bicycles that shift gears the same way by kicking the cranks back, but none of them, to my knowledge, have two redundant chains, and certainly none of them have a freewheel mechanism of that sort that was invented specifically for the Buffalo. Freewheels in general are extremely reliable, but this big heavy one with two chains on it, it's even more reliable because let's say it fails. Presumably you still should be able to use the bicycle because the other side of the freewheel may still be working. So despite the fact that a feature was actually added to the bike, the reliability has not been affected at all. Now this idea came to fruition during a series of meetings and field tests where derailleurs and internal gear hubs were absolutely tested, but the added benefits never outweighed the low cost and dead reliability of the original single-speed drivetrain. That is until an engineer at SRAM suggested they do this. And as a side note, it's interesting what engineers come up with in the absence of marketing departments. But the idea was genius, and yes, it's heavy and crude and all the other things that I mentioned, but it turns out that doesn't really matter when it allows you to climb a hill with 15 gallons of milk. So the engineers at SRAM drew up the plans for this freewheel, they delivered it to World Bicycle Relief free of charge, and initial field tests were very positive. People loved this. Those field testers found it to be a lot more reliable than internal gear hubs and derailleurs, and they found it to be plenty functional, but they had to work out a few bugs. For example, there's no way to tension each of these chains individually, and so they had to experiment with different gear ratios until they found one that worked for the application while also providing semi-even tension on the chains. And as you can see, one of these chains is a little looser than the other one because they couldn't find a gear ratio to get it perfect. But it turns out that doesn't really matter. It's still reliable and it's still functional. Even so, introducing this new freewheel mechanism did open up a can of worms, so let's put all those worms back in the can one by one. As you may know, the original Buffalo bicycle used a coaster brake for reliable stopping power. A coaster brake functions by kicking the pedals back to stop. Now that's not gonna work on this bike because you kick the pedals back to shift gears, it can't do both. And so the Buffalo S2 uses rim brakes, which let more worms out of the can. See, rim brakes make contact with the rim in order to stop the bike, and so the wheel has to be somewhat straight in order for them to function. That wasn't the case on the original Buffalo. It had hub brakes on both the rear and the front, and so you could ride around with completely bent rims and the bike would still stop just fine. But that bicycle used big, heavy steel wheels, which were really strong and really cost-effective, but really difficult to get back into alignment. And so they had to do something different on the Buffalo S2. Most bicycle wheels can be trued. Truing involves adjusting the tension of spokes to bring the wheel back into alignment. And indeed, the old Buffalo bicycle could be trued. It was just really difficult. They made it a lot easier on this one by using box section aluminum rims. These are plenty robust, a little bit lighter weight, and a lot easier to true. There are any number of brakes they could have chosen for this bike. I was not expecting dual pivot caliper brakes. These are pretty easy to work on and they provide a lot of braking power. I'm just surprised they were able to get ones that were so inexpensive. Truth be told, these are more finicky than coaster brakes, but they're easier to service than the drum brake that was on the front of the old Buffalo. They're plenty reliable and easy to work on, and I think it's a fair trade-off for this unique shifting mechanism. But let's revisit wheel truing for a moment. I've mentioned how it's a fairly easy task to do roughly. You can use a zip tie or a finger or something as a gauge, and then any spoke wrench from a multi-tool to adjust them. But it's still a fairly specialized task. We wouldn't expect Georgina to do it. But since the introduction of the original Buffalo bicycle, World Bicycle Relief has laid quite a bit of groundwork. I did mention those Buffalo bike shops, of which now there are over 100, and there are also 3,500 trained Buffalo mechanics in the communities served. In Georgina's case, the Buffalo bicycle has doubled her output. That creates more jobs, and those jobs often require a Buffalo bicycle, and so you can see the machine at work. Many of these communities now have the resources for a slightly more advanced Buffalo bicycle, and that might have been suboptimal 10 or 15 years ago. But even where communities have been elevated to the point where they have more resources, they're still somewhat self-reliant. And so included in the box with each buffalo are a bunch of tools to get you started. This stamped steel box wrench is normally the kind of thing that I make fun of, but it's kind of great when it's the only wrench you have, and included are pretty much all the sizes on the bike. Also included is this air pump, which is arguably the most important tool a bicyclist should own. They also included a very light duty cable lock, which I guess is enough to keep people honest, and they included a tire lever for changing flats. But they didn't stop there. They actually included this little freewheel tool, which is how you repair or replace this freewheel that makes the bicycle shift gears. So let's do that and have a closer look at this freewheel. Now, as you can see, I'm working on the bike upside down. That's the recommended way to do it, and that's how a lot of the Buffalo mechanics work on the bike. I'm also letting air out of the tire so that I can get it past these caliper brakes. Now, if you're performing a repair back here, you're probably more advanced, maybe at a Buffalo bike shop, and so you would have a bigger wrench to turn this freewheel tool. But it is nice that they have the freewheel tool there, because I bet adjustable wrenches are kind of common in these communities. Now, this is remarkable. All the shifting is inside of one part. At the backside here, it performs just like a normal freewheel. And so, like I said, if this mechanism fails, you would still be able to use it. So you can see it's turning the freewheel there. If we backpedal, now it's just pedaling and not doing anything. This gear is disengaged, therefore this one defaults. It's crude, it's simple, and it's kind of brilliant. Now, if like me, you grew up riding BMX in the late 90s or early 2000s, you might look at a freewheel as a throwaway part. When it goes bad, you just buy a new one. But actually, I've revived freewheels that didn't work before. You can get them running again with some WD-40. And so it's a small, simple part that's easy to ship, and chances are you're not gonna need a new one for a really long time. So I have the bike now on some pretty rough gravel roads, which are not unlike the roads that the bike would be used on in Africa. Although this is pretty gnarly. This is like mountain biking. Now, right now I'm in the cruising gear, which feels a lot like the gear on the original Buffalo bicycle, and it allows you to pedal and go pretty fast. But if I were to turn around here, going uphill, it's really, really hard to pedal in this gear. I'm actually standing up and pushing down as hard as I can. So I'm gonna give it a pedal kick back. Now we're in a low gear. I can climb a pretty decent grade without much difficulty. It's not super low like Eagle, but it gets the job done. And then it's gonna flatten out here. Let's kick back. Now we're back in the higher gear and we can cruise. We can get up to some pretty good speeds here. Wow, pedal kick. We're back in the low gear. It works so well. Now, despite all the new capabilities a lower gear offers, the original Buffalo bicycle is still being manufactured and it's still being widely distributed. This new Buffalo bicycle, the S2, is for communities that are a little bit more advanced and ready for it, or communities where you need to pedal a big jug of milk up a hill. But just like its predecessor, it turns out the Buffalo S2 makes for a pretty good people carrier. In East Africa, a Boda Boda is a motorcycle or bicycle providing taxi service. So what better than a nearly indestructible bicycle with a rack rated for 200 pounds? And as I mentioned in the last video, this steel is heavy enough for stick welding. And so Boda Boda drivers will customize these bikes with foot pegs and cushions. I often carry my toddlers on the back of my cargo bike, which has gears and is designed for carrying people. Yet I've considered installing an e-bike motor on it for assistance. I would be a little bit embarrassed for these Boda Boda drivers to know that I've considered that. Now, I mentioned last time that this audience, you guys, are responsible for mobilizing hundreds of people all around the world. But World Bicycle Relief informed me that the response from that video, from this audience, went well beyond those donations. It has led to visibility and outreach that has furthered their mission. And so just by watching this video through and sharing it with people, you're actually contributing to the cause. But if you do have some extra coin and you want to buy Buffalo bicycles for people in need, you can do it through the link in this video. And if you're wondering how much more this bicycle cost than the last one, it's actually only about $15. And so we're still providing simple, sustainable, highly serviceable bicycles to communities that can absolutely use them. And so depending on where it's being delivered to, every $200 donated is more than enough for one Buffalo bicycle, which actually mobilizes multiple people. You guys are the most awesome audience ever, not only because you contribute to causes such as this, but also because you're willing to geek out with me over a heavy steel commuter bike with two chains. It's incredible how the internet brings together like-minded people from all over the planet. I hope you found this video enjoyable. I hope you learned something. And if you didn't, I hope you at least found it entertaining. Thanks for riding with me today, and I'll see you next time.